Good morning everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's Belinda here from Visualized NZ, and I'm back today with a scrappy activity for you, a scrap busting one. I wasn't going to do a scrappy video today. I was only going to do one a week, but this came to me last week, this idea, and I've been playing around with it and I just really love it. It's quick, it's easy, and it's satisfying, and I really like the look, so I hope you will too. So you need scraps, and literally the smaller the scrap the better. So I don't know if you're like me and keep like the most ridiculous tiny scraps, or whether you're actually more sensible than what I am. But you know, I just like these scraps are cool, and these are the scraps I'm going to be using. So literally the smaller scraps you've got are great for this. If you don't, then just use your bigger scraps and tear them down more. And you need some double-sided tape, and that's all you need for this this activity. So my tape is 1/2 inch, so about 12 millimeters wide. You can use whatever width tape you like. I wouldn't go too thin, but this works out really well, and it just so happens it's the one I've got the most of. I've got a thinner one, but the thinner one would be too thin for this project. Okay, so I'm just opening out a length, and I'm going to hopefully do two in the video. Excuse me. I'm going to do a neutral one and a coloured one. So I'm just going to grab one of my scraps and see, like, I just tore that tiny scrap in half. And I'm just going to lay it over top. Now, the idea here is to let it hang over the edges. Not heaps, like you don't want it like overhanging heaps. But you can make it as wide or as narrow as you like. And I prefer to have torn edges. So if I've got room to tear off a straight edge, I will. But not the end of the world. And then I overlap them slightly. Just slightly. So I go in with another piece. And so there will be an edge there that's not stuck down, and I don't mind that. If that bothers you, then you might need to either go in with some glue or not overlap them so that the whole piece is stuck down on the tape. And I just keep going, layering bits. So this wee scrap I can just put down as is. And I want it to be uneven, so I don't want the sides to line up straight. It's going to be very, very scrappy. Perfect for a scrappy, scrap-busting activity. And if I put some down, then I can go along later and tear off bits that are a bit too long. Whoops, sorry about that. I didn't put my phone on Do Not Disturb. So hopefully I won't get too many. Might just move it away, further away from the camera, might help. So if it does that again, it won't be so loud. And so just layering up and building your scrappy strip. So I've been thinking what to call these, and I think maybe scrappy tape. Decorative scrappy tape, I don't know, something along those lines. It's not really important what we call it, is it? And just keep building. Oops, there's a neutral bit, put that over there. And you can do a colour theme if you want, you know, if you have a particular project in mind that you want it to match, by all means, do whatever suits. But I'm just going completely random with my colour choice. I'm just grabbing bits, laying them down, and calling it good. What could be easier? So you can even lay side by side. And let's use up some of these bits. Now with a straight edge, sometimes I'll leave the straight edge and it will be the bit that gets overlapped so you don't see it. which is a good way of dealing with it. So hopefully everyone's having a good day wherever you are in the world. I'm feeling a bit more flu-like today, so I was not sure I would do a video, but here we are. It's hard not to. I enjoy it. It's fun, and I love being creative. So, you know, I might as well turn the camera on as well, as long as my coughing doesn't drive anybody up the wall, round the bend. Right, get rid of this last little bit of this painter paper. So the types of scraps I've got here is a bit of everything. I've got wallpaper, scrapbook paper, painty paper, magazine paper, book page. Right, now I am going to throw that tiny wee bit away. So whatever paper you've got, bits of envelope, as long as it's made of paper, it's all good. And I like this because you don't have to sew it, you don't have to embellish it because there's no real room for embellishing it. It just is as you make it. Right, and generally I'll make these about as long as my journal page, just a wee bit longer, which gives me some options. On how to use it. So where would you use this? Well, down the side of a page. Let me grab a page out. I did have one. Where have I hidden it? Oh, I've buried it. Just give me a moment. No, I've buried it well and truly. So I'll just grab this bit of paper and pretend this is a journal page, because it could be. And you can use these to decorate down the side of your page, like so. See? I think that looks super cool, and I love the scrappy nature of it. You can use it to decorate the bottom of a pocket, or top of a pocket, a belly band, anywhere that you want some decoration. You can cut it into small snippets and use it like a cluster on the side of something. So use your imagination, anywhere you'd put a cluster or some decoration, that's where you can use it. Right, so this one is just about long enough. And so I'm just going to put that last piece down and trim it off. Now I've just got a little bit of tape left there at the end, so I'll just put a little snippet so we haven't got tape exposed that'll stick itself to things. There we go. Quick, simple, easy, and just, I think they look super fun. So imagine there's a belly band down there, down the centre of a belly band, or a sideways belly band. Just super fun. Right, so now I'm going to do another one. This time I'm going to do the neutrals, just so you can see the different look. And the neutrals one is actually my favourite. I love the look of it. And it fits with anything you're doing. So it's not limited by the colours that are in it. So I've got all sorts of book text here, dictionary, foreign language. I've got some crossword in here somewhere, some music paper, some graph paper. Some brown paper bag, some printables that were neutral. What else have I got? Some pattern paper from a like a cross stitch or something. So lots of fun texture in these neutral ones. Brown paper. And some of this packaging paper, I'm not sure what it is, but I love it. Came out of some sort of product, and I've got very little of it. If I knew what it was called, I could perhaps track some down and buy some. But here's a bit of stuff out of a woodworking book or magazine or something. Can't even remember. Different bit down beside it. So I hope you really enjoy this and we'll give it a go. Have a play with it. You can really do it to suit however you want it to be, using whatever scraps you've got. And make it as long or as short as you want, and then use it however you want. I mean, what sort of project is that? That's, to me, is like so usable. Lots of different ways you could do it. And you can see how quickly it comes together. Right, here's some of the crossword. Some German book page. I think it's German anyway. German or Dutch, can't remember. Just going with another bit of dictionary. And you could make these really long if you wanted. I just prefer to do them in lengths of about what I'm going to use. Otherwise I'll have to curl it up in a roll. And I might damage some of the paper because it does overlap. So there are bits that aren't stuck down. And I'm just not sure how that would work. So I just like to use it, do it in usable lengths with a little bit extra so it gives me some flexibility. Please excuse me. Right, here's a bit of printable. It's got a cool font on it. Put it upside down, why not? And oops. If you have problems with your roll staying upright, then just wedge it between a couple of things to hold it in place. Generally, I find it sits up fine. Right, how are we going for length? I think that's probably about, yep, that's a good length. So give that a trim off. And there we go, we've got two done, and I've been going for 14 minutes, give or take, on the video. So, super quick, really cool. And I'll show that on the page. I just think they're fun. So there we go. There's a little scrap busting idea for you. Give it a go. Let me know how you get on. Feel free to pop into the Facebook group Visual Vibes and show me what you've done. I'd love to see. And how you've used it as well. Would be super cool. I do have some I used on my personal journal. Doesn't show it particularly well because of all the things in the background, so maybe if I put this behind it will show up better to get rid of the distracting elements behind. But here I've made one, so I've did one strip and then I cut it in half and put it as a trim on the bottom and top of my journal page. So that's how I've used it in my personal journal so far. So yeah, give it a go. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks for joining me today. Bye for now.